Good evening, and welcome to this guided sleep story. I'm grateful you're here with me. Tonight, we'll paint our mind's canvas with the most beautiful imagery to find peace and calm before we fall asleep. Sometimes the hustle and bustle of work life can become overwhelming. Occasionally, we need to break off from the monotony and travel through the world to be reborn. Tonight, we will imagine a trip through the country, exploring the many vistas and beauties. Your trusted dog, Max, will accompany you on this adventure, where you'll find peace, relaxation, and calm. Before we start, let us find stillness and allow our minds to synchronize with time's ceaselessly flowing river. We will harmonize our consciousness with the fleeting moments of the here and now. Let the past and future melt away. Allow your mind to relax. Shake off all the stress and worries of the day. You will wake up in the morning, brimming with positive energy. Tomorrow is another day to smile and live life to the fullest. Snuggle into your comfortable bed and adjust your body in the most pleasing orientation. Ensure that none of your bones and muscles feel any strain. Now, empty your mind of all extraneous thoughts by focusing on your breath. Whenever you find your mind diverting, bring it back to your inhaling and exhaling. Now, bring this process under your control by breathing more slowly, more rhythmically. Keep doing so until you feel your muscles loosening calm and relaxation washing over you. You have done a fantastic job and should be proud of yourself. Taking that first step towards self-love and self-care is the most essential thing. And that is what you have done. You are now ready to embark on your adventure of the imagination. Remember, this is your story. These experiences belong to you. Now, close your eyes and imagine. You are having breakfast in the van with Max, your canine companion. The morning sun slants in through the window. There are other vans in this parking lot. People like you, out on a rejuvenating road trip. The parking lot is nested between tall trees, pine trees. You munch on your breakfast and sip on your coffee. The van is warm and comfortable. A cozy mobile home with all the things and facilities you need. You have a small refrigerator installed and a folding table for your meals when inside. Max eats from his bowl, wagging his tail, and enjoying his meal as much as you. After finishing up, you go to the sink and wash the dishes, including Max's bowl. Stretching your limbs, you step outside and let the sunlight soak into your skin. It is a beautiful day, cloudless and bright. Ideal conditions for driving through the mountains. They dominate the skyline, the mountains, reaching high into the heavens. The parking lot is at the base, a spacious road meandering away and up from the parking lot. You greet some of your neighbors before putting the leash on Max. He's been growing restless, urging you to take him for his morning walk. The air outside is cool, and you wear warm clothes before going on your morning walk. Max expresses his joy as he leads you along the jogging track nearby. The exercise melts the stiffness from your limbs, energizing you for the long drive ahead. You look up at the mountain. There is a camping spot up there with a beautiful view. That is your destination. Going back to the van, you clean up and make your bed. Changing into comfortable clothes, you put the key in the ignition and turn. The van comes to life. Max settles down next to you in the passenger seat, wagging his tail in excitement and anticipation. Laughing, you pet him on the head and tell him he is a good boy. You put the van in gear and drive out of the parking lot. On the road, you feel your heart floating like a balloon. All the stress and hassle of the workaday world are washed away from your mind, body, and soul. Lowering the windows, you let your face get buffeted by the winds. Max puts his head out of the window too, relishing the winds as much as you. The road is empty for as far as you can see. The road slowly winds around the mountain. On one side, there is a cluster of pine trees shading the road. The mountain face is on the other side. The van hums pleasantly as birds fly overhead in flocks. On the side of the road, you see several little animals, and you slow down to appreciate the beauty of the trees and the flora and fauna surrounding them. Max also watches these sights with fascination. There are squirrels and hopping rabbits. Tiny birds pecking on the tree bark, looking for food. You cruise by and let these sights sink in and elevate your sense of lightness. The journey is long and will last the entire day. You pat Max on the head, ruffling his shaggy hide. Your van ascends up and up the mountain. The trees become thicker, and the animals more exotic. You see rare birds flying by. Like a free human, you think about nothing, worry about nothing. Instead, you live in the here and now, in the beauty of the mountain. You see a sign for a diner, and the sight makes your stomach grumble. Max looks up at you, and you know he's thinking the same thing. You promise to prepare his food in a bit, as the diner is only a few miles away. The sun progresses along the sky as the clouds drift by, nearer than you remember seeing them. Thoughts of coffee and hot food engross you as you continue to drive up the mountain. Finally, the diner comes into sight as Max excitedly jumps in his seat. You have arrived at a beautiful plateau, with the diner perched upon it. Parking the van in the lot, you get out and stretch. The long ride has made your muscles stiff. You walk around for a while with Max. getting back inside the van. You prepare Max's lunch. His favorite biscuits are served in his clean bowl. You watch him eat up with relish. The sight brings you enormous joy as you scratch behind his ears. Once Max has eaten his fill, you put the leash on him and head out for the diner. There is happiness suffused in the air, a lightness that only traveling can bring people. With his belly filled with food, Max is calm and serene. He attracts the admiration of others. They ask your permission to pet him. You smile and assent, grateful for the love gathered by your companion. The diner welcomes dogs, and you enter and find a table by the window where you feel like eating something sweet and crunchy. The diner is well known for its pies. You order a slice of blueberry, one with a steaming cup of coffee. Max curls up at the ground beneath your feet and observes his surroundings in peace. You are glad to have him with you on the trip. The most agreeable companion. Looking out the window, you see the woods stretching into the distance. The forest lies ahead. And you are excited to imagine the beautiful sights that await you and your companion. Before long, your slice of blueberry pie arrives, along with a steaming mug of coffee. You take your first bite and feel a carnival in your mouth. A culinary festival of exquisite taste. The crust is nice and crunchy, and there is an orange touch to the blueberries. Every bite of the pie elevates your spirits further until you feel your sense of taste satiated. with your belly filled with delicious food. You sip your coffee and feel the warmth and freshness spreading through your body. You feel your head clearing and your body energized. You are ready for the last stretch of the trip. Paying the check with a generous tip, you leave the diner with Max by your side. You get into the van and rev the engine to life. You pull out of the parking lot and resume your journey. The road you drive through now is carved through a dense, vibrant forest. You see birds in the trees, twittering and chirping. As you ascend, clouds begin to engulf the roads as the sun is dimmed out. The clouds soak up the sunlight, appearing golden in the blue sky. Finally, the road leads to the camping grounds, a plateau adorned with flower beds. A lovely fragrance hangs in the air. You park the van, and with Max by your side, set up for the night. The sun is setting, and a gentle rain begins to fall on the van. The sun peaks from behind the mountain, splashing the sky with the colors of red and yellow. The sky dominated by the mountain is a breathtaking sight. The day now done, you snuggle into your sleeping bag while Max gets comfortable on his cozy little bed. The sound of rainfall is a soothing lullaby. The day is now done. A new day awaits tomorrow. There is nowhere else to be. Nothing else to do. You drift off into a deep and restful sleep.